Hello everybody, Glenn Denman here. I'm not really working on the bus, but I am messing with the bus. I'm gonna take the bus for a spin here in a minute. But before I do, I thought I'd just kind of show you a little bit of work that I had to do to it. It's kind of noisy here. The engine's already running. So I replaced this valve here so that the other one leaked. And also replaced this hose here for the power steering. Anyway, so I replaced the power steering hose and the valve that goes to the tanks for the airbags in the back there. So I went ahead and replaced that stuff, and the one valve just leaked a little bit, so the airbags would overnight, you know, go down pretty quick. But that valve was actually leaking through the valve, so I went ahead and put a new one on it. And then also I replaced that hydraulic line serving the power steering pump, because that thing's leaked ever since I got the bus, and so I haven't driven it since I replaced that. So I thought today would be a good time for a drive. I'm going on a 3-week trip to Texas, not in the bus, unfortunately. This is the trip that I was trying to get the bus ready for, but I just wasn't able to get it far enough along for the trip, so I'm just going to drive my pickup. So we'll be gone for a few weeks, so I thought I'd go ahead and put this video together before we go. Anyway, I'm just going to take the grandkids up for a little drive, just for about 10 miles or 15 miles, just to take the bus for a run, since it's going to be parked again for another month. So it's a good idea just to run the bus every once in a while, keep it going. So anyway, appreciate everybody watching. We'll see how that drive goes. Hi, my name is Glenn, this is Karen, my wife, and this is our bus. Okay, when you pull that door shut, okay, go ahead and pull it shut, and then slide that little latch over. Yeah, that one, there you go, good, thanks. Now we're ready. Okay, I'm gonna go up a little bit, hit the brakes a little bit, and see what it's like there, buddy. Not bad, huh? Got it tied off pretty good for this little trip. Mm-hmm. Is it hot?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's hot. now and then the grease gets dried up and stuff, you know, you gotta keep stuff spinning on.
Yeah.
Like, leave your car sit for a long time, after a while it starts to rot away.
Reads over full on the gauge, even though I've driven, you know, a little bit.
neighbors here. I used to actually live in Tampico, which is about another 6 or 7 miles up here where we're going. There's a big park lot and a church and everything up there that we'll be able to turn around. So I used to drive this road every day back in the day.
Thank you.
beautiful downtown Tampico, Washington. Unincorporated town, if you even call it that. So we used to live way up in the hill up there.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. See the shiny roof up there?
Yeah.
That one of those shiny
roofs. With the two trees?
Yeah. Church, and the fire station, and a closed down store.
big car, you know. I'll teach you how to drive it. Huh? I just think it'd be great to drive a bus. Maybe next year. How old are you now? 11?
Yeah.
Yeah, give me another year on it. We almost bought that house right there. Yeah, you guys were going to live in it.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
Man, gave an offer on it, got beat out. Somebody overbid us on it. then I'll have to go back.
Well, that's it for the drive today. Went up to Tampico, Washington. It's an unincorporated town. I wouldn't even really call it a town. Anyway, it has a church and a restaurant and a store. The church is still operational. The store isn't. The restaurant's not. The church actually does pretty well up there, and it has a fire station up there, and my mother-in-law goes to the church up there and stuff. We used to live up there. So anyway, it's a nice place. Nice drive. Appreciate everybody watching, and hopefully we'll get some more videos out pretty soon on the progress of the bus. So take care, everybody.